Hello friends, welcome to RedBush Technologies. Today I will explain you a very interesting and good project of Java, that is movie booking system. So to get that project, first visit our website redbushtechnologies.com and go to this project bank. Under project bank you will find a project of various technologies. So you need to go click on this Java NetBean projects, and here we have this recently added movie booking system project. So click on this, and here we have the brief introduction about this project, what exactly we can do in this project. And once you click on this download project link, the screen will be opened, wherein you need to provide your email ID, and the complete zip file of this project will be mailed to your on the specified email ID. But before pressing the submit button, press this like and subscribe button of our channel, so that in future, whenever we'll be adding a new project, you'll get an email notification. So this project is basically a simple text-based project, and we haven't used any graphic concept in this. We have mainly focused on logic and algorithm part of the current movie booking systems which we are using nowadays. So in this project, there are two modes, admin and guest. So when you will be entering in the system as a guest, you can do two. You can either book a movie, you can view all the list of all the movies available in the system, or you may exit from the system. As an admin, when you will be logged in to the system, you can do lot of options over there also. You can add a new movie into the system. If you wish, you can update an existing movie. Let's say I want to change the timings, or let's say language of the movie I want to change. So all that part you can change. And if you wish, you can altogether delete a movie also, or you may exit from the system. So all these features are there in this project. So once you download this project, you'll get this .java file. So this is a complete project or code of this project. So in this project, we have taken care of all the validations which are possible, like let's say once the system is, a user is in and he is trying to book a ticket, and he is basically giving a movie which is not available in the system. So obviously you should be getting an error instead of getting it booked. So all that validation part is already there in this system. So if I run this project, let me run this so that you can see the running project, running code. So to run this, click on this button on, and you'll get the all the available options. So I'm having this one. If you want to admit, enter as a admin. Two and three are for guest. That means if you press one, that means you will be logged into the system as a admin. And in two and three, there will be no credentials which will be asked to you, and you will be directly using the system as a guest. So by pressing 2, you can list all the movies which are available in the system. By pressing 3, you can book a ticket. So let's say, check them one by one. Let me enter one. Okay, I need to press username and password over here because I'm entering as an admin. So basically we have set username as admin and password also as an admin. If you give any other combination, it won't accept because this is the validation which we have checked. If you want, you can change in the code and you can give some other username password. So once you are logged in to the system as an admin, you can do all these options. If you have you'll supply some incorrect username or password, you'll get an option for a message for that this username is incorrect, please provide a correct username or a correct password. That way you'll get a message. So let's say I have entered correct username and password. So now if I press, I can choose all these options. So let's say I'm pressing 1. So that means I want to add a new movie. So it will ask for the movie name. So let's say this is my movie. The language it will ask. This is my language, and let's say this is my movie time. Now this movie has been added. I'm getting this message that movie added. If you wish to cross check if it has been added in the system or not, just go to the previous menu by pressing 4. and you are back to the previous menu. And here we have this option 2. So if I press 2, that means I can list, I can show, see the list of all the available movies. So this is the list of all the movies, and see the recently added movie which has I has just added is also there in this list. So this way we can cross check. So let's say again, let's check other options. So I need to say admin again. Okay. So we have seen how to add a new movie. If you wish, you can update a movie. So let's press 2 over here to check this. So it's asking which movie you want to update. So let's say 11. Let's say if I press some other number, let's say 19, so which is not there in the system, right? So you will get a message, please enter valid movie number to be updated, as this number is not in the list. So we have put all these validations everywhere. All the validations has been checked. So let's say 11. Okay, I can update that because it's there. If you wish to change the movie, then add a new movie name, or you may select the same one. And let's say I want to change the language from Hindi to English. So I'm putting the new language. Enter the timings also. I want to change 6 instead of 4. Then it has been updated. Similarly, the same way, we can go to the main menu and check it if it has been updated or not. Let's press 4. We'll be back on the menu, main menu. And let's press 2. See, my movie has been updated, both language as well as timing. So let's see the last option also, that is delete. So again, I'm entering as an admin. So now by pressing 3, I can delete a movie. Just press 3 and it will ask like which movie you want to delete. I'm saying 11. So it's saying movie deleted. Cross check by pressing 4 and then the same number 2. So see, it's not there. So this way we have checked all the options which are which an admin can do, right? We have checked like how to add a movie, how to update a movie, how to delete a movie. By pressing 4, we can return to the previous menu, and by pressing 5, we'll be exit from the system. So let's press 4 and we'll be back to the main menu. And we have seen this first option of main menu. Second, we have seen like through this, we can just have a list of all the movies. And by pressing 3, I can book a movie. So let's try for 3 now. 3. That means it's asking like which movie you want to watch. So let's say I'm saying 10. If instead of 1 to 10, you pass some other number, you'll get a message because we have put this validation that user can book only that movie which is there in the list. So number of seats, let's say 4. Then same, the class it's asking for. So let's say I'm saying 5, which is not there. So it's say incorrect class. So we need to press either 1, 2 or 3 because these are the only 3 class options available. So then again date it's asking, month it's asking. Let's say I'm entering 14, which is an incorrect month. So you'll get a message over here. It has to be a correct message. Year, let's say we are saying 1918 and movie has been booked. We have got this message that you have successfully booked your movie, and these are the details. Movie name, your language of the movie, show timings, your audi, your date, your number of tickets, your class, your total cost. So this is how we can book a movie using this movie booking system. And by pressing this last option, exit, we can exit from this system. So this is how this movie booking system works. So in this project, we have put all the validations. We have used all the major concepts of Java, like your arrays, your loops, your if-else. All part has been taken care in this functions. So all these concepts have been used in this particular project. So anybody who want to submit a project in Java, either they are the school student or they are the college student, they can use this project because this is a very good project, and you can directly show this in your school or college because you need not to do any modification. It's already running and it's all the validation part is, and everything is been taken care of. So you just download it and use it. So we keep on adding such type of projects on our website. So if you really want to have an update, like when we are adding a new project, you can just like and subscribe our channel so that you'll get an email notification. Thank you so much.